The Maker Pen. Rekum's tool to create beautiful maps like this one. I didn't make this. I couldn't make this if I had a gun to my head. I've always admired Rekum creators who spend days making these maps for us delinquents to enjoy, but I thought to myself, could I do something like this? Could I conjure up a room as beautiful and as peaceful as this? No. But I can certainly try. So the first thing I had to do was to create an idea. Cool video game ideas. Floating islands is actually like kind of promising. Lush floating islands suspended in the sky. So I had the idea and I had the motivation. So I got on Rec Room and filmed 40 minutes of footage at 15 FPS. And all I have to show for it is this clip. Fuck. One bitch baby temper tantrum later, I got back into it. The second step was to start building. Through a few very helpful YouTube tutorials, I got the idea of the drawing board and into reality. Okay, so I'm making a floating... Shit, what was I making again? Floating islands. Okay, I'm gonna start by doing the terrain. I followed a really easy tutorial by this guy called 4Orc that taught me the basics of Rec Room terrain. So I have to get a good color. Yeah, here we go. Oh, green sand. Perfect. Fuck yeah, man. This is coming along so nice. It's gonna be the floor of my island. Dodecahedrons. For the base of my... island. I keep forgetting what it's called, but I'll get there eventually. After a bit of trial and error, I brought my... Wait, what? An island! I keep forgetting! After a bit of trial and error, I brought my island to life, and it was beautiful. Yeah! I might make some diamonds at the bottom, actually. Oh, ooh, this could work. Dude, I fucking love that. Yeah! And that is how you do a fucking island, baby. Oh my god, I'm so proud of myself. Now I need to really quickly rewatch this tutorial on how to make trees. The next tutorial was from a bloke called Tonic who taught me how to design this luscious tree. Start at the bottom, you work your way up. The higher it goes, the thinner it gets. Oh my god, looks like a fucking beer pot. No! My game crashed! After blood, sweat, and tears, and hours of work, it's not gonna save. It was all gone. My game crashed. Name and publish this room by- Fuck off, coach! I was hopeless. I was losing faith by the second, but I was still determined to keep myself from rotting off YouTube for another 6 months. So I went to bed. And hope that the next day would present itself with a slightly better result. I logged back onto Rec Room, rejoined the game, and I went crazy. Like super cyan crazy. Just pretend that's funny. I was learning new things every step of the way. I learned things like what an octahedron is and tube fat. And despite my infuriating controller drift, I was finally making progress. There we go. So now we have some terrain. I'm going to save the room this time. I'm going to design a couple trees over here. There. Cool. So we got our tree branches. From the tutorial, it had kind of like thinner branches. That's such a cute little twig. Yo, that isn't even that bad. Bam! I am happy with that. We're saving the room again. With the trees out the way, I moved on to the next order of business, rocks. I'm so good at drawing. Y'all got nothing on me. There we go. Cool. I'll do like a couple different variations of this. Okay, so now we have trees and we have rocks. I'll decorate this first island with, you know, just trees and rocks and stuff. So I'm picturing kind of like those Minecraft skyblock island kind of things. My island is finally starting to take shape. I just needed a little more pizzazz. Pizzazz. So the next thing I want to do is I want to add like a little kind of bench. Yeah, that's nice. Cool. All right, we have a bench. And after some final adjustments, the first island was complete. I'd say that's a pretty good first island. Day one finished. I am so tired and I'm gonna do the rest of this later. But I'm not gonna lie, the progress I've made now is pretty freaking good, considering how terrible I am at the maker pen. Hopefully the next time I step back into this room, I have a few new ideas I can come up with. I was supposed to say something funny, but I kinda ran out of ideas. Oh, fucking sh-
We shape our buildings, thereafter they shape us. Said some very important person, I think. I found this quote on some random sketchy website, and it motivated me to keep building. If I can make a beautiful island, then maybe I'm a beautiful person, right? Right. Today I wanted to work on the second and third island so I could get an idea of what I wanted the whole map to look like.
I want to build the second and third islands. I have a small one and then another big one. The plan was to make three floating islands that you could travel or teleport to. Each of the... What the fuck? Come back!
Each of the three islands have their own trees, rocks, and a way of getting there.
Now I've got three islands. I need to figure out how I'm gonna get from the up there, down here, and then up there again.
I eventually landed on designing a portal that you can walk through that'll take you across the two main islands, then make a rock parkour to get up to the third one. And to learn the skills I needed to design a portal, I created a respawn thingamajiggy that attached it on the whatchamacallit that automatically does the thing.
Simple. I'm so confused. How do I do this? What am I doing wrong? Yes! Yeah, baby, I did it!
I didn't use a tutorial. Of course I didn't use a tutorial. You used a tutorial!
Using my knowledge from this, I'm gonna make the teleporter. My god, I'm amazing!
You know what? That's good enough.
Ho ho ho! This is gonna look sick.
It in fact did not look sick. Using my newfound respawn knowledge, I made two portals to connect the islands together.
Alright, let's try out my portal. Let me through. Yes! Oh my god, I'm so proud of that.
Can I make the glass a different color?
Oh! Yes! You can! You can!
Okay, so we should now have multiple working portals. Some of these rocks from down here. Oh, and some of these can just like be floating because... Why not?
Am I cooking or what?
Yo.
Oh my god. I love this!
Day 3 was an absolute success. 85% of the map was finished and all I wanted to do was to add a target practice game on one of the islands. Little did I know that when I get on the next day, things would get so much worse. I'm kidding. I just said that for dramatic effect. Day 4 was a breeze. I added 3 different targets and a bow that would respawn if you let go.
Okay.
Oh shit, wait, okay. So it might not be respawning. I don't know why this is not- Oh, never mind, we're good. Let's do some target practice, huh? I missed. Might have missed. Might have missed.
After adding a few light sources and some finishing touches, I was done.
I'd like to sing for you a very wonderful oldie entitled... Unforgettable.
I did it. I made my own game all by myself. I was always so scared of trying the maker pen and building in general, but now that I've done it, I'm actually quite proud of myself. Don't judge the horrendous looking trees or the mediocre looking rocks. I did it, and you know what? I'm so glad I did. That's it for the video. I really hope you enjoyed this one. I don't really do videos like this, obviously, but you know, I wanted to try something different for a change, and I actually really like having the constraints of this box around me. I don't really know what to say. Subscribe, that's definitely something I need to say. Like the video, maybe. You can leave now, bye.